In this video, I'm going to talk about getting started with push notifications in your app marketing strategy. I'm Dominique from Hurree, the platform that optimizes market targeting through automated segmentation. What are push notifications? Push notifications are messages sent by app marketers to their users. Each push notification delivers a clear call to action to prompt the audience engagement. These short messages contain media-rich elements like images, video, and are sent out to users when they're not using an app. Why use push notifications? Push notifications are one of the most effective tactics app marketers have in their arsenal. Correctly implemented push notifications can boost engagement rates by 88%. And when it comes to those all-important app retention rates, a correctly formulated push notification strategy can boost figures by 180% in the first 90 days. It sounds too good to turn down, doesn't it? So where should you start? The first thing you should do when thinking about mobile push notifications is clearly define the goal of your app. At the start of 2019, the Google Play App Store had 21 million apps available to download, and the Apple App Store wasn't far behind with 18 million. So when people say there's an app for everything, they're not joking. Considering just how many apps there are, it makes sense that at least some of them miss the mark. Take the iShaver Pro for example, a razor simulator app for those times when you just want to have a virtual shave. No wonder churn rates are so high with these one-use wonders clogging up the App Store. Avoid wasting your time and money by clearly defining the long-term goal of your app from the very beginning. This will help your market targeting within the App Store and keep your users engaged. Well-defined and successfully scalable apps generally fall into one of three broad categories. Problem solving. Apps that make product researching and purchasing more efficient. Think ASOS or Uber. Entertainment. These are apps that provide content like games, videos, and articles. Think Candy Crush or the BBC News app. Added value. Apps that give you an added service such as music streaming, price comparison, or product reviews. Think Skyscanner, TripAdvisor, or Spotify. Once you know what you want your app to do, consider what user behavior you wish to provoke. Do you want your audience to engage with content, make a purchase, or just interact with other users? Only after you have clearly mapped out the goal of your app can you begin to think about sending push notifications. But first, in order to actually send notifications to your users, you must of course gain their permission. Depending on which operating system you have chosen to run on your app, you may be subject to a permissions process. This means you need to ask your users for the right to send them notifications. The processes of Android and Apple differ, and so do their notification opt-in rates. Android runs a passive opt-in system that requires users to grant permission before installing the app. To deny permission, at this point, users face a manual opt-out process. As a result, Android has a 91% push notification opt-in rate. Users prefer the path of least resistance. Apple, on the other hand, has an active push notification opt-in system. Shortly after downloading an Apple app, the user is served a dialog box that explicitly asks them to grant or deny push notification permission. This dialog box can only be launched once and is often met with a negative response from users who are unfamiliar with the benefits of push notifications. Perhaps this is why Apple has a meager opt-in rate of just 49%. One way to avoid losing your user permission is to launch a pre-permissions campaign immediately after they download your app. A pre-permissions campaign serves branded messages to your users when they first launch your app. These messages explain the benefits of push notifications and how opting in will improve their user experience. After all, isn't great user experiences what all marketers strive for? Only after a user has completed the pre-permission stage of onboarding will you launch the official dialog box asking for push permissions. Now that your users understand why you want to send them notifications, they will be far more likely to opt in. Before sending push notifications, you must first understand your audience. Who is your audience? What matters to them? and what can you do to add value to their day? These are the questions you should be asking yourself before you start sending push notifications every which way you can. Today's app users are tricky customers. And why shouldn't they be? They know you have enough data to provide a near perfect user experience, and they'll be quick to leave if they don't get it. What happens when you have hundreds, if not thousands, of push notification recipients all expecting top-notch UX and content relevant to them? It's just not possible to go through each contact one by one. You need to break down your audiences into smaller, specialized chunks in order to deliver the value they deserve. Enter segmentation. Audience segmentation is the process of dividing your data into manageable, logical groups based on various shared characteristics. You can segment your audience based on four key factors. First up, demographic data. This includes name, age, gender, etc. Second, behavioral data. That's purchases, cart abandonment, in-app activity. Third, geographical data. That means location, urbanicity, climate, and more. Lastly, psychographic data. That's your audience's likes, dislikes, values, and opinions. Segmented campaigns produce more conversions than non-segmented spray and pray methods of communication. This is because segmenting your audiences acknowledges that every user is different and delivers content that is both meaningful and valuable at each stage of the consumer journey. You're ready to take off. Now that you've considered your goals, permissions, and audiences, you're ready to start creating your push notifications. So get ready to see your engagement skyrocket. And of course, we'd like to hear from you. Are you going to put these tips to the test? Or maybe you would like to share some of your suggestions. Let us know by leaving a comment below. Want to find out more about how Hurree can help you maximize your potential? Simply click the link in the description. Nurse having their arsenal. Or maybe you would like to in the description. Can't read that part.
That just says the cue from